Now, on the sidelines of that event, President Marcos allayed concerns about his health. Marcos skipped the reception dinner of the 31st annual meeting of the Asia-Pacific Parliamentary Forum on Thursday evening. Philippine Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri said Marcos was feeling unwell after his six-day trip to the U.S. from the APEC summit.
I basically just ran out of steam yesterday. Hindi pa ako nakapag-recover sa biyahe. I just needed rest. I'm fine now. Thank you for your concern.
The Armed Forces of the Philippines says the joint patrols of the Philippines and the United States were successful. That's despite the shadowing of a Chinese Navy warship Thursday morning. AFP Chief of Staff General Romeo Bronner Jr. notes there were no untoward incidents reported during the three-day activity. Bronner adds the Chinese vessel's shadowing was already expected.
This is one way for us to promote the rules-based international order, no? Because we believe that in the conduct of these joint patrols, we have to follow the international rules and laws. So we have done that, and by doing that, we are telling the world, no, that this is possible. It's possible to operate within our exclusive economic zone, no, without necessarily harassing other countries. No? This is one message that we are telling the world.
In response to the joint patrol, the Chinese military says the Philippines has enlisted foreign forces to patrol the South China Sea and has been stirring up trouble. It adds Beijing will maintain high vigilance and will resolutely defend its sovereign and maritime rights to ensure peace and stability in the disputed waters. Moving on, the Philippine Disaster Agency is validating two reported deaths due to heavy rains and widespread flooding in eastern Visayas. Some 879,000 people were affected in the region. A total of 47 cities and towns are currently under a state of calamity. The country's House Development Mutual Fund, or the Pag-ibig Fund, has prepared its calamity loan for members in need of aid. The agency has allocated funds for members affected by the floods in eastern Visayas and a magnitude 6.8 quake in Mindanao. Eligible members can borrow up to 80% of their total pag-ibig savings at a rate of 5.95% per annum, the lowest rate in the market.
Parliamentarians attending the 31st Asia-Pacific Parliamentarians Forum failed to arrive on a consensus regarding two resolutions promoting regional peace and stability in the region. Senator Ronald De La Rosa, who chairs the Political and Security Matters plenary session, says the Chinese delegation opposed many provisions in the draft resolutions submitted by the Philippines and Indonesia. Senator Francis Tolentino also confirmed De La Rosa's statement as he expressed his disappointment over the development.
Kahapon, umatend ako nung dapat na monitor na yun, yung working group on China, anything about maritime, anything about UNCLOS, anything about rules-based, ayun. Siyempre, frustrating yun, pero bahagi yun ng rules dito sa EPPF.